back. This is Gender Discourse, and today we are debating what a Delhi court has said regarding sex on promise of marriage, which he says may not always be rape, but at the same time, he does think that it is immoral. Well, folks, you still have some time to reach us. Do pick up your phone and call us at 1-800-111-5314 or 2303-5420. Having said that, we are joined by Gopal Yadav from Maharashtra. So, Gopal, if you can hear me, please go ahead.
Yes, yes. Yes, madam. My question is that, madam, our Indian society is not giving permission of pre-marriage sex. And government has to take some law and legal action against it, madam.
You really think so? Who needs permission for premarital sex? From whom?
Hello?
Okay, let me put this to the panelist here. Yes, Khadija. So we do have these kind of mindsets also, that they think it should not be permitted at all in the first place.
See, I'm saying first thing, very important. Forget about morality. Morality, I feel that anything is crime when it comes under the ambit of the Constitution of India. Nothing else is crime. So, morality issue is like tear it and throw it into the dustbin. Morality is no issue. The other very important issue which all women have to understand is that when I'm riding a bicycle, I don't need a helmet. But when I ride a motorcycle, I need a helmet. I don't need a helmet to save others on the road, but I need a helmet to save myself. When I'm going out and trying something new, which is not a traditional thing, I don't, for this, by saying this, I don't say that the traditional things are safe. They are much more worst. But when I'm taking a new step, I should be careful enough. Protect yourself, be safe, and play well. That's all.
well said, I think. Sudha, you want to counter that?
You know, really, in society, the issues around premarital sex have to be discussed more openly. We tend to push these things under the carpet very often. You don't like talking about sex, about physical relationships, intimacy, etc.
True.
See, first and foremost, we have to realize that the age of marriage has got pushed back. And with great difficulty, the government is trying to implement the law on child marriage. See, even now there are certain conservative forces, casteist and conservative forces, which are trying to push that back and, you know, push towards lowering the age of marriage and trying to, you know, shift it back. All this is wrapped up with this. It's linked into this. What is it linked to? It's linked to the fact, you know, this purity of sex, whom you can have sex with. And remember, this is mainly for the woman.
True.
The man sexual relationships, but not the woman. So it is linked up to that, and there is an attempt to push it back. That is part of that. You know that you need a law which will look at controlling or preventing premarital sex. I'm afraid it is just not possible. Even if you look at rural areas, villages, you will find that there were many such relationships taking place, and actually, you know, it was taken quite normally, even by certain communities, etc. No big deal was made of it. It's this whole certain kind of morality and conservatism creeping in, along with this upper caste and so on and so forth, that you see being reflected now in the discussion taking place.
That's right.
So really, much more frank discussion, open discussion. And girls and boys, younger age, being able to move together as friends, being able to have relationships without unnecessary baggage. Without being forced into exploitative situations, because you also have to be aware date rapes, etc., are taking place.
Oh yes,
place.
Those are also
There's a
reality. Whole
thing
That's
of
I'm
violence
sure Dr.
also
Manju
along
must
with
be.
That.
Yes.
So all these kind of things that are part of the the trends these days. So keeping all this in mind and making sure that you are you have certain safeguards and not
in
vulnerable
that is
to
true.
Exploitation
that is true.
And you can
that is
go
true
ahead.
I think that is the message that really needs to grow
that's
across
right.
when we
and
talk of independence
the main message I still feel is feel is to the judges that the judges cannot get away with this kind of extrajudicial and wrong kind of notions messages being messages being put into the judgments. That is not acceptable.
True.
That is wrong, and we appeal that judges should not do this.
True. Now, Dr. Manju, I'm glad she mentioned about this date rape and all that, because on the pretext of being independent about themselves, about their bodies, about their sexual entities, this is also a reality. These youngsters, especially the teenagers, are taking things a bit too far, something which they cannot really handle themselves. So I think that is where some constraint, as you also mentioned somewhere, is required. So do you also get cases like these? Are these on the rise in any way?
They are on the rise. Mm-hmm. And of course, these days in the school itself, the friendships are increasing, where sexual involvement is increasing quite a lot. And in this case, definitely we need to have certain rules and regulations, because one is early parent pregnancies are very harmful for the health of the young girls.
Correct.
Secondly, also with so many HIV and other things are on the rise, so medically also I feel that it is important to have certain control over your impulses, and learning to control these impulses is one of the positive things that should be there, and this should be through parenting or through discussions between parent and children, and also it should be among peer group also. Some these things should come up,
and some education also needs
to
be given.
Yeah, it's very important
youngsters.
To that.
Right.
It is very important. But I also want to add on to another thing, that the law where is also these days being said that the consent of both the partners is very important. Earlier, the females would just surrender themselves.
Correct.
Which is now being considered that if this are forced upon, that is a rape. So it should not be a forced thing. So women should realize their rights. But
true,
they should not take it to the extent that in the genuine cases they do misreporting, and then they take
absolutely advantage
of
this.
Well,
we have a viewer with us. Let's see what he has to say. This is Deepak from Delhi. So Deepak, can you hear me, please?
Yes.
Deepak, please go ahead.
My question is, what would be the impact of this living relationship in rural areas? As we can see in Indian context, there is a big difference in the perception of urban people and rural people. So what would the impact if this kind of Western culture comes in India?
Okay. Especially in rural India, that's what you want to know. Okay. So, impact of these kind of living relationships in rural India, that's what he wants to ask. Any comment
on
that?
See, these relationships exist in rural India as well as in urban India. As ma'am has mentioned, he would not be unaware, but in Indian traditional societies, very ancient societies, there are so many castes where living relationship was already existing. Living relationship is not a very new thing for
Correct.
Indian culture. It has been there, but it has been there without violence into it. It was a very porous relationship, very equal kind of relationship, and there was this existing. And you know, like, why we are so afraid of impacts? If it is a equal relationship, it's a non-violent relationship, it will not have a negative impact. In fact, it will have much more positive impact on the society that if it's a open relationship. But if any relationship, for that matter, even marriages with violence exist in a society, it will create a violent society, it will create a disruptive society, it will create a bad society. So any relationship between men and women, which are either marriage or marriage-like relationship, both of them, if they are there with violent traits into it, it will always create a bad scene in the society. It will create disturbed and distressed children. It will create a lot of criminal mindsets into people, criminal activities that happen. So the whole system will break down. But if relationships with very understanding, with gender just relationship exists, it will not create any kind of problem.
No.
In fact, it will give a lot of sexual maneuverability to the society, which can be like much more powerful, which will make much more powerful the men and women,
especially
both.
The women, that's right. Now, Sudha, finally, I think, you know, a pronouncement like this coming from a judge, does this really mean that our society probably has not really moved an inch? because if these are the kind of pronouncements or judgments.
No, I won't say that it has not moved an inch. I would say that there are changes taking place, but not all the forces are able to recognize this or relate to it or move along with it. And so there is a contradiction, there is a conflict, and there is an upheaval also. So you do have one conservative section trying to sort of,
that's
you know,
right,
come into the
because
space.
A judgment that is coming in Delhi is totally different from what is
boys.
Coming in Chennai.
Well, let us say that, you know, boys and girls, there are youngsters who are coming to out now in very healthy relationships. I think basically the issue is of commitment, basically a certain maturity and a certain commitment. But this whole question of sex in our society, I think in that we must have a more sensitive, insightful sort
just
of open discussion.
Right.
And see, for example, sex education in schools. There was opposition to sex education in schools, if you remember.
Yes, yes, yes.
There are certain states even
which
now
simply,
they have actually banned
correct.
Sex education in schools. Why? So, you know, having counseling, having normal relationships between boys and girls, I mean, these things one has to think about. So, create the possibility of an environment, a society where equal healthy relationships are possible.
That's
I think
right.
this is the way forward. And make sure that you know, the violence, the exploitation, the you know, the subjugation, that part of it, that in some way there is this message, strong message sent that this will not be tolerated in our society. I think that would be the way forward.
Absolutely. I think you've really summed it up very well, Sudha, I must say. Well, on that note, let me say thank you to all three of you for coming today and for discussing this threadbare. So thanks a lot, ladies. Well, friends, this debate of sex before marriage, immoral or not, and sex on promise of marriage may not always be rape, is an ongoing one. A debate like this is bound to take place in a society that is in transition. The pace at which India is moving will definitely spring up many issues like these. But the way we deal with these will decide how we place these pieces of the puzzle together. The society has to sooner or later take this change into consideration and widen its views and be more accepting of today's realities, as most of my panelists here have said. What would raise eyebrows a couple of decades ago may have no significance today. Likewise, the issues that throw up debates today may not be significant a few years down the line. So on this, one thing is sure, the changes in society are bound to happen. It's just that we need to keep a steady pace with it. On that note, it's a wrap of this debate. Do catch me next week with another interesting discussion on another gender issue. Till then, this is Lottie Alaric saying goodbye and take very good care of yourselves.